This stuff is pretty toxic and cancer-causing, so I'm going to use a silicone hand here.
What's going on, everyone? My name is Dr. Fayez, also known as Life of a Doctor. I do a reaction video to summarize all the crazy medical videos that made it online, so let's get to it.
This stuff is pretty toxic and cancer-causing, so I'm going to use a silicone hand here.
So we didn't want to get any of the cancer-causing substance on our hand, so we used a silicone hand, but then you... What? Alright, so by now, I hope everyone using an epinephrine pen knows that blue to the sky, orange to the thigh, that is the common teaching when it comes to epinephrine injections. Now, one of the most concerning things about this video was the fact that she injected epinephrine into one of her fingers. Now, any distal part of your body, like the fingers, the toes, all these have very limited blood supply. So what epinephrine does is it acts as a vasoconstrictor by clamping down on your arteries. Now, when you inject a high concentration of epinephrine into those tiny little blood vessels that are the only things supplying your fingers and toes, there's a high risk of necrosis. And what that means is that there's a high probability of you losing that finger. All right, looks like we got someone's arm. Oh my. Oh, that looks painful. So what we just saw is what's known as a non-union. Now this is what happens when you break a bone but never get it fixed. Now these non-unions, people can still function and use their arm, but all that's left holding it in place are the skin, the tendons, and the muscles. There is no way that's real. So I was a little skeptical at first that this may have been like a prop or something like that, but no, this was actually 100% real. Now this person was a hiker and he ended up losing his fingers due to severe frostbite. Now when people think of frostbite, they think it's a painful process, and sometimes in the beginning it really is, but when it gets this severe, when you're talking about third, fourth degree frostbite, your nerves are completely destroyed, so it's actually painless. Alright, so this may blow some minds, but one of the leading theories to why you taste iron while running is that it's actually your own blood. Now inside your lungs you have tiny capillaries, and these capillaries help transport and oxygenate hemoglobin. But when you go running, your blood pressure actually increases, and this causes some of these tiny capillaries to burst open, releasing hemoglobin into your lungs. Now that hemoglobin contains iron, so when you go to exhale, the iron is actually picked up by your taste buds, and that's why you taste iron. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, please like, subscribe, helps push the video out there for newer audiences. And I'm planning on doing more of these reaction videos as well going forward. So if you enjoyed it, let me know in the comments. I'll see you next time.